What I would say was the best creamed potato is a potato with lots of butter, no cream, milk. But what we're doing now is we're making the potato for the cottage pie. And so we're going to have the potatoes, the egg yolks, the butter, and a tiny bit of milk. Why the egg yolks? To help it brown when it goes in the oven. As simple as that. But if you're just going to serve it with a classic beef bourguignon, with any braised dish, with any fish dish, just the butter and the milk. That's it, as simple as that. These potatoes have been baked. They've not seen water. The reason why we bake them, so no water gets into them. How many times have you had creamed potatoes which are all wet? Because the potatoes have been boiled and not drained or dried properly. These were baked, wrapped in tinfoil and baked on salt. And if you want to make the perfect mash, after you've done this, then what you should do is then pass them through a drum sieve of very fine tammy, which makes them even finer. But for a dish like cottage pie, shepherd's pie, it's not necessary. And one of my favourite ways of eating potatoes is baking them, scooping them out, crushing them with a fork, a little bit of seasoning, olive oil, some fresh parsley, and serve it with grilled fish. Or a bit of olive oil in there instead of butter. Delicious. I started with a kilo of baked potatoes. So that would give me a prox weight, net weight, without the skins, of about 700 grams. So now what I'm going to add to this is a little milk. We just scald it first. Otherwise you're adding cold milk to hot potatoes. And a little butter. If you were going to make the creamed potatoes for fish or for meat, and not for the shepherd's pie, you put more butter inside and no egg yolks. But you can see how smooth it is. Some people put cream in their creamed potatoes. Be quite honest, I don't like it. I never do it. Butter and scalded milk. Straightforward. Okay, add a little milk. You see, just bring it in slowly. For something like a cottage pie, something like a shepherd's pie, it's about texture. You don't want it too wet. Because the last thing you want is when you put it on top of your pie, it dropping off. And then I'd say three egg yolks. And there's the perfect mash for a cottage pie, a shepherd's pie, a fish pie. It's not too wet and it's not too heavy. It's got texture. And it's got great flavour because those potatoes are baked.